And welcome to the episode on weekly newspaper and periodicals, different sections and their functions. Today, we'll learn about the various departments that make up a magazine. We'll also look at the roles and functions of these individual departments. We will see what are the challenges faced by the magazine industry today and what the future holds for our magazine and periodicals in the age of digital media. The lessons has been prepared by Mr. Vidhanshu Kumar, who is a journalist and academician. With close to 15 years of experience, Kumar has served in reputed media houses like The Asian Age, IBN 7, NewsX, BBC, etc. And I am Finaz. So, what is a magazine? Magazines are publications, usually periodical publications, that are printed or published electronically. The above statement means that magazines come out at fixed periods, usually weekly, bi-monthly and monthly. It also implies that magazines are either published on paper, that is printed, and these days magazines also come out in digital versions as they are published electronically. Daily newspaper and periodicals differ in size, format, page layout, overall design and printing techniques. While pages of most daily newspaper measures 41 cm into 56 cm, magazines or periodicals tend to be around 27 cm into 20 cm. However, they are weeklies such as the Sunday Mail, the Sunday Observer, or even the weeklies edition of daily newspapers, which are registered as weeklies. They are also of similar size, look and design as the daily newspaper. Some of the noted magazines or periodicals in English in India are India Today, Business India, Femina, The Week, Outlook, Open, Carva, Computers Today, etc. While the basic principles of editing, printing and production remain the same. Magazines are considered a luxury while a daily newspaper is considered a utility item. Magazines are read at leisure, have a longer table life span and are evaluated differently by the readers and advertisers. Let us now have a look at how magazine work is divided and what are the various departments in a magazine. Bruce Wesley divides magazine world into three basic categories. Each of these departments is distinctly different, yet each is wholly dependent on the smooth functioning of the others. These areas of the responsibility are usually referred to as business, mechanical, and editorial. Working newsmen is more likely to call them in order the front office, the back shop and the newsroom. Magazine's editing is actually only one operation among the several in the newsroom. But the editors particularly must know how other branches of the total newspaper operate in the order to their job with maximum efficiency. The copy desk is essentially the crossroads between the editorial and mechanical branches of the business. The copy editor must know the mechanical phase pretty thoroughly in order to perform his editorial function. The business office is the counting house of the newspaper profession. It has an obvious duty to keep the organization afloat financially. The magazine business office operates pretty much like any other business office. Usually, the entire operation is directed by a business manager to whom each of these department head is responsible. The business manager function often is handled by the publisher himself, especially in the case of smaller dailies. The advertising department headed by the advertising manager ordinarily has four divisions. The local or retail division consists of a staff of specialists who solicit, lie out, correct and sometimes merchandise local advertising accounts. Another group of specialists concerns itself with obtaining and handling foreign or national advertising accounts. This division deals directly with the advertising agencies which handle the accounts of the big advertisers, usually with the help of an advertising representatives in metropolitan cities, a service which intercedes for the newspaper directly with the agencies. Classified ads have gained steadily in recent years as a source of magazine revenue and hence are receiving increasing attention by magazine executives. A fourth division of an advertising department is the merchandising or service division. Its purpose is to assist the advertiser in getting the maximum return on his advertising budget. This is the most recent and rapidly growing phase of magazine advertising and engages from a part-time troubleshooter to a complex research organization ready to provide a potential advertiser with detailed information on the buying habits of the magazine readers with reference to his particular product. Circulation is another major division of business of a business office and is usually headed by a major executive, the circulation manager, since the newspaper ultimately stands or falls on the basis of a number of steady readers that can be enrolled. The circulation manager may have any or all of the following subdivisions under his supervision. City circulation. It involves the maintenance of circulation records for the city of publication, the recruitment, supervision and reimbursement. The supervision of the city, taking responsibility for moving papers to the newsstands, relation with the newsstand operators, etc. Area circulation. Responsibility here includes getting papers destined for the surrounding area into the mail and operation of a fleet of tempos, taxis to carry the papers into the surrounding areas where mail service is not rapid enough. The circulation manager is also in charge of moving the papers into the appropriate distribution channels as they move into the mailing room from the press room. It involves the direction of an office staff to keep records, notifying subscribers when these subscriptions need renewing, the handling of complaints, new subscriptions and renewals over the counter by mail, etc. Promotion is essentially the public relations department of the newspaper, where a separate promotion department exists and usually responsible for initiating promotion policies subject to the approval of publisher and usually coordinates the promotional activities of other departments. The entire mechanical operation is usually under the supervision of plant superintendent, who is directly responsible to the publisher. In a typical situation, he will have five departments. The basic function of each is composing room. This is the point of chief contact between the editorial side and the mechanical side. It is this department that copy is set into type and the type is assembled into magazine pages. The type is set by automatic typesetting machines such as the linotype, straight matter or the body type is set according to instructions on news copy sent from the newsroom. Headlines are set from similar directions. Ads are first set into type and then assembled on the basis of instructions on advertising copy from the advertising department. All of these materials are then assembled into magazine pages, following the instructions on page dummies. Stereo department. Here, newspaper pages are run through a series of steps which prepare them to be clamped as curved plates of metal onto today's high-speed rotator presses. The vast majority of dailies use rotator, web perfecting press, which means that the newspaper is printed on paper which feeds from the huge rolls and impression is applied from the curved plates which rotates at high speed. This requires that the pages be converted from the flat form in which they are originally made up to the curved plate from which they are actually printed. Engraving department. Many smaller magazines have insufficient need for the art to operate an engraving department, having the work done commercially instead. However, most large magazines find this economical to their own work. Photo engraving reduces news pictures and other newspaper art to form in which they can be printed. In the case of a photograph, the job is to screen the picture in such a way that an etched metal plate is produced with a surface of dots. Press room. Rotator presses can turn out magazine at phenomenal speed. They not only print but cut, fold and trim the newspaper and deliver them directly to mailing room. Proof desk. In a sense, proof desk lies by the side of the mechanical, editorial and advertising departments, but is usually responsible to mechanical superintendent. Its object is to correct all typographical errors. A proof is taken of all material set in the composing room, including ads and editorial matter, by inking the type and taking an impression of it on a rather simple proof press. These proofs can be compared with the copy to make sure that the two confirm. The primary concern of the copy editor in the organizational chart of his magazine is, of course, the editorial department. Here the description is not as easy since very marked differences are discernible from one magazine to another. However, a typical organizational scheme would go something like this. The editorial department has two sides and usually these are separately responsible to the publisher. They are news and editorial. The news side is usually under the supervision of managing or executive editor. The editorial page crew consists of editorial writers and is directed by a chief editorial writer, an editor or editor-in-chief, or sometimes an editorial page editor. All stories designed from the newspaper, whether they come from the typewriters of reporters and rewrite men or the several wire services, teleprompters and other source requiring editing. This duty falls chiefly on the copy reader who sits on the horseshoe shaped table called the desk. The independent or separate desk system in operation on a large scale allocates the news of different readers, each of whom has his own team of copy readers. The editor with the crew edits the news designated as cable, teleprompter, city beats, society, business, finance, sports and reserve news. The copy reader, also called the desk man, rim man or mechanic of the editorial room, is the anonymous and frequently unappreciated collaborator of the writer. Newsmen or correspondent who see his blue pencil flay their cherished proofs have no words or phrase for him. On a big desk, the copy reader may edit from 10 to 15 columns. As he picks up the copy and reads, he forms general conclusion about the story in hand. Has it news value? If it hasn't, then it is not worth reprinting. Is it accurate and fair? Inaccurate and uncertain items not wanted by a good magazine. If at all he selects anything which is dubious or doubtful, he takes the responsibility for published inaccuracy. Is it libelous? An item that contains words or implications that may get the paper into legal difficulties has to have the danger spots eliminated. Is it complete? Is the treatment fragmentary and partial? Will it leave the reader up in the air? If so, its detail must be rounded, with or without the help of background materials. If the item meets these qualifications, the copy reader starts his editing to fit his paper's requirements. These requirements may vary, but generally we take it that the paper requires. Clearness. The reader must have no difficulty in finding out what the story means. Condensation. The copy reader must read and condense each story to be the length assigned to it. Condensation applies to the words, not the ideas. Style. The copy reader's style has nothing to do with literal quality. It refers to particular rules which his paper has laid down for spelling, punctuations, capitalization, abbreviations, use of numbers, and like. Arrangement. The copy reader's notion of arrangement differs from that of the literary man. It is based on the convention of the lead, which puts the important parts first and least important parts last. The copy reader aims to have his subheads make divisions in the subject, each division meant for something new and not merely for repeating what has been already told. The copy reader usually faces three problems: to tighten up the story and thereby speed up the action, to reduce the story so that a telegraphic editor could splash it in a page one box if he chose to handle it that way, to cut out the excess matter and bromides. Although the copy reader works enormously when he constructs a good headline, he feels the pleasure of a creating artist with short words and in short compass. He can tell a whole story. He knows that the headline must fulfill two requirements. It must attract attention to the story. It must announce the story's main facts. He sees to it that each headline he concocts does both. Now let us look at some of the production aspects of magazines. The cover pages of periodicals have special significance from the editorial and newspaper's policy. While about 85% dailies are subscribed to and delivered at homes or offices, more than 50% magazines are looked at before being bought. Hence, the magazine covers have special significance. The cover page of each magazine issue is a real challenge for a page designer. It is a challenge because the designer is expected to incorporate into the design the following points: aesthetic attractiveness, color variety, uniqueness to attract attention, an invitation to purchase content, and effective temptation to buy it. For a magazine's success, a lot depends on its design. Limits of imagination of a page designer determine the limit of page design for a magazine. However, there are few factors that make some designs more suitable than others. Every magazine has a history behind it, which gives it a tradition in cover design. This tradition or the past pattern of the cover page design tends to set the standard for selection of the alternatives, which may or may not be suitable for a particular magazine. To attract the new readers, a magazine will need to adopt unconventional designs, but too much variations from the past may also tend to alienate the regular readers. To study the design pattern trends, take a look at 3 or 4 issues of the same magazine. You'll see common or regular features in the designs. The final test for a magazine is at the newspaper or magazine sales stalls. The success is measured by the number of readers willing to pay for it, and that determines its paid circulation. To understand the sales promotion strategy, we have to find out first the readership profile that an editor and publisher of a magazine have in mind. The readership profile is defined in terms of age group, educational level, marital status, disposable income, nature of job, quality and place of residence, consumption pattern, etc. Most general interest magazines are read by a wide spectrum of people in different age groups, income levels, educational standards, etc. The readership profile is defined in terms of groups and percentages. Another factor that tends to influence the price and cover design of magazine is the long-term sale promotion strategy of the newspaper management. Therefore, editors and publishers, in case the management adopts the sales promotion policy of promoting newspaper, though newspaper stalls, the magazine cover design acquires strategic sales promotion importance. With the onset of digital media, print media has taken a hit and magazines are some of the worst hurt. Magazines face many hurdles and pitfalls, and they need to take care of these obstacles. the readership in the newspaper or magazine is built up slowly. With the pass of the time, readers get addicted to nature and the quality of the news produced in the particular formats and theme. So the question arises, how much change should be done in each issue? It always depends upon the subject matter, topics to be covered. In most cases, the change is always reflected from the topics, language illustration, and other factors such as article layout. Pictures and illustration indicates the degree of change. It should be kept in mind that picture should not vary from earlier issue, but the competition with other magazine and newspaper should always be seen and approached. Whenever the last minute changes have to be incorporated, the effort is to incorporate the required changes or include the new items with minimum disturbance with overall layout. Event which demands last minute change usually require prominent display. Magazines are facing tough challenges worldwide. In the United States, magazines continue to struggle with the sales of subscriptions and newsstand copies in the first half of 2013. But they made inroads in selling digital editions according to data released recently. Total paid and verified subscriptions declined by 1% in the first half of 2013 and newsstand sales, which are often an indicator of a magazine's appeal, dropped by 10%. Both declines were similar to the overall trend in the same period a year ago. Among the hardest hit by the drop in newsstand sales were weekly celebrity magazines and women's titles, which have struggled to compete with rival content online. Big names like Vogue and Vanity Fair also had problems at the newsstand. Vogue sales declined by 10.4% and Vanity Fair's by 11%. In a surprising development for struggling news weeklies, Time showed modest growth of 1.2% in newsstand sales. The numbers released by the Alliance for Audit Media also shows that a solid base of loyal magazine readers was simply turning to the digital version of magazines. Digital replica editions, which replicate the format of the print editions, now make up 3.3% of total magazine circulation. With 10.2 million digital replica editions sold in the first half of 2013. During the same period, in 2012, magazines sold 5.4 million digital editions, which made up 1.7% of circulations. Clearly, they have fallen sharply, but digging deeper into the numbers demonstrates that what shoppers look for from magazine has shifted. Not as much as some may say, but shifted nonetheless. While celebrity publications are still by far the largest category, they have also lost the most sales. Much of what those magazines provided is now available from a wide range of new media and much more quickly than weekly. The magazines that have done well at retail in the recent past have provided content that is best presented in printed format. The most notable examples are the Food Network magazine and SCTV, but they are not alone. A number of enthusiastic titles are doing well. Other big gainers this past period were Brights, Men's Fitness, Fast Company and Incorporations. That's a pretty broad range of topics, but the print format apparently works for them and their readers. As for distribution, that should be a great concern for all publishers. Wholesaler distributors operate with essentially fixed cost, warehouses, handling system, trucks and personnel. Over the years, those costs have already been pared to the bone, with an estimated 40% decline in dollar volume over the past 5 years or 6 years. The strain on their economics has been severe with the last 6 months. 5 smaller companies have closed down. The large survivors, while having other resources, cannot be expected to continue to operate under a demonstrably fragile economic model. The tablet platform provides less a savior than simply part of the mix for many magazine companies. The magazine industry entered 2010 curious as to what Apple may launch. It entered 2011 excited by the possibilities of tablets. It entered 2012 a bit more optimistic as Apple had launched the newsstand, and it entered last year on a mission to make digital work for them. 2014 begins with many magazine publishers more leery of their digital futures than they had been just a few years earlier. Many excellent tablet editions have been launched. A few new smartphone editions have shown what can be done on those devices. But the promises of the newsstand has not come to pass, at least for the majority of publishers, as Apple has let the newsstand devolve into an overcrowded mess, filtered with titles that only a year or 2 years earlier would have been rejected by the app review team. Meanwhile, neither Google nor Amazon has yet come to with exciting new digital publishing solutions. So, as we can see, magazine sales have come under immense pressure in the US as well. The prime reason being rising popularity of digital magazines. Also, distribution costs are also adversely affecting sales of magazines printed on paper. It is also seen that those digital magazines are selling more which already have their print version. Independent digital magazines are still trying to make their presence felt. According to a report by FICCI KPMG, the magazine industry witnessed a growth rate of 1% in 2012 and was valued at INR 13 billion. As readers demand more focused content, the demand for the general content category continued to decline. The industry feels that general content and news magazine is a fading segment, whereas special interest magazine and niche contents magazines have good potential to be of interest to readers with a monetization potential in the long run. The top magazines in India have shown negative growth in quarter 3 of 2012 as compared to quarter 3 of the year 2011 as shown in the graphic. According to this survey done by IRS, number 1 magazine in terms of readership is Vanitha, followed by Pratyogita Darpan, Samanya Gyan Darpan, India Today, Saras Salil, Meri Saheli, Karmakshetra, Malayala Manorama, GK Today and Cricket Samrat. The trend is similar for Hindi magazines. As we can see, the top magazine is Pratyogita Darpan. It is followed by Gyan Darpan, Saras Salil, Meri Saheli, Cricket Samrat, India Today, Grah Lakshmi, Grah Shobha, Champak and Vanitha. And now let's say the trend in top English language magazine in India. The number one magazine is India Today, followed by General Knowledge Today, Reader's Digest, Competition Success Review, Outlook, The Week, Stardust, Pratyogita Darpan, Business Today and Wisdom. Globally, magazine readership in most categories has been declining primarily due to free content availability on the internet, easy access to information from various sources and changing lifestyles, making time availability a premium. Similar trends are being noted in India, with 8 of the top 10 magazines witnessing negative readership trends. As per IRS surveys during 2011 Q3 and 2012 Q3, industry believes that revenues for magazine will not go down, but the sources of revenue are undergoing a change as there is more contribution from non-subscription based areas. While advertising, sales and subscriptions may contribute a large portion of the total revenues, together events, innovation and digital presence are also adding to the top line. So we can clearly see that magazine industry is facing steep challenges both internationally and here in India. However, in India, while the growth areas are regional and vernacular magazines, digital magazines are also beginning to make an impact. So, to summarize, the three major departments are editorial circulation and advertising sales. All of the writers and art directors, photographers, designers, creative directors, fashion people, depending on the magazines, are all editorial. Circulation is subscription marketing and newsstand sales and other marketing related to the subscriber database. Advertising sales, including salespeople, sales director, as well as marketing and events. The other departments are production, the people who lay out the magazine and work with the printer and buy the paper, etc. And then are corporate departments like accounting, finance. The introduction of free magazines by newspaper is one of the main reasons why existing magazines are taking a hit, and competition is going to get stronger in future. That is all for today. Hope to see you in another interesting topic. Till then, thank you for watching. Goodbye.